what can we put in our album to fill it up? And so he's walking down the street. All of a sudden, this cab stops next to him, and John Lennon and Paul McCartney walk out. Can you imagine? I would just, you know, die. And I have this romantic view of London today. I have this vision that I'm going to go to London, and around every street corner, there's going to be a rock star. And I, you know, and with my luck, well, anyway. And so what happened, I mean, I could just imagine that, you know, you're just wandering around, there's John Lennon and Paul McCartney. Oh my God. And they're like, what's wrong? He says, well, we need a song. And they're like, oh, we just wrote one. You can have it. In other words, they've just given you gold. That's like somebody walking up on the street and say, oh, I got 100,000 shares of Apple. I don't want them. Here, you have them. I mean, and the Beatles recorded it too, but I think the Stones did a better job. Because the Stones were the harder edge. They were the bad boys. The Beatles, even your mom liked them.
Well, and they cultivated that.
They did. So, now, they even did an advertising campaign saying, would your mother let you date a Rolling Stone? And of course the girls are like, yeah, that'll tick off mom. All right, yeah, because this is good. I want to be all emotion, and I think that's what rock and roll is all about. You know, that's why I don't like Pat Boone sitting there and he's going up to the degree, oh Rudy. And meanwhile, you've got Little Richard going, bop, 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 bop. That gets your attention. And, you know, he's moving. All right, well, what happens with the Stones? They're, you know, they're putting some emotion into it. And also, Brian Jones playing guitar, he could play. And John Lennon and George Harrison, you know, wonderful musicians, but as far as guitar players, not in the same league. And I'm a guitar nut. I mean, that's another thing, you know. I've always thought, for the most part, the best way to set up a band is you have a guitar, two guitars, a bass, and a drum, and you're good to go. Every once in a while, throw in a little bit of keyboard, piano, or organ. Don't overdo it. Maybe a little bit of horns. Once again, don't overdo it. You see, what happens is people, they get a new toy and they overdo it. And then they ruin it. I mean, it was best in its natural state, where you could just hear those instruments and hear the vocals. Now, then we've got some other British invasion bands. Some of them you may have heard of, some of you haven't. If you haven't, The Animals. Oh my God. Eric Burdon, one of the best blues vocalists in British rock history, or in any history. I mean, oh my gosh, one of my favorites. I want to see him. He's like 70-some now, but I still want to see him. That's one of those things on my to-do list if he ever comes close. Because, man, they played some. They could play. I mean, he could sing unlike... You know, I can't imagine Pat Boone singing House of the Rising Sun or Don't Let Me Down or any of those. And then Herman's Hermits. Oh, hey guys, I've got news for you. Herman's Hermits, led by Peter Noone, the original lead singer, is coming to Highland Springs. You mean you're not running and getting tickets?
No.
What?
They just played at Disney World, John.
Well, they did? Oh, man. Well, but you see, they're going to be in Highland Springs. And, of course, I saw it online, and I was like, I went to the official ticket buyer of my family, my wife, because whenever I go to buy tickets, I have trouble with the websites. That doesn't work out well. And she always, you know, click, you got them. Well, anyway, they haven't gone on sale yet, evidently, because they're coming in July, so you have plenty of time to make your plans. And there are two shows. The old Henrico movie theater. Anyway, you know, Hermits, they were more of a soft, kiddie type band, but I remember them in second grade. And so, when you remember some of this stuff from your childhood, when you get a chance, you go. Like, I saw the Monkees a few years ago, before Davey died. And man, it was a great show. I love the Monkees. I go see them again. They deserve to be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, unlike some of the people they put in. My gosh.
Tell them about driving your parents crazy with that Henry
Gate. Oh, Henry Gate. There's a song called Henry VIII. It is nothing about the famous British king. I used to sing that in the back seat of the car. You know, and of course, mom and dad couldn't escape. And so then they'd have to hear it. And it sort of irritated them, which is probably why I did it. But do I have Henry VIII on there or no? I've got to sing that.
No, I'm just saying it's a never-ending song.
Oh, yeah. Henry VIII, it's great.
You don't have to sing it, I'm just saying.
Oh, yeah, you've heard it.
Can you look it up?
Yeah. They'd like to hear it.
Yeah, you've got to hear Henry VIII.
Mr. Franklin played it for us. I never
remember
that.
Oh, Henry VIII is amazing. Well, anyway, while you were waiting for Henry VIII, they also had some other good songs, and I'm hoping, because sometimes when bands like that play the small venues, you can get autographs.
Thank you.
Oh, yes.
I'm Henry VIII, I am. Henry VIII, I am. I got married to the widow next door. She'd been married several times before. And everyone was an Henry.
Henry!
Wouldn't have a willy nor a son.
No son.
I'm a right old man, I'm Henry. Henry VIII, I am. Second verse, same as first.
And the same thing is, Peter.
I'm not sure you would have made it to your destination in my car.
Well, yeah, I'm surprised I did too. Anyway, but Peter Noon, and the thing is, he's one of those guys who never ages. He doesn't look much different than that now. You know? Anyway, and then one that is also one of my favorites. This was, you know, for a while, if you were from England, they'd sign you. Some of these were really good, some wasn't. I mean, Brian Epstein, the Beatles manager, had many bands that made big hits. Jerry and the Pacemakers would be a good one. And, you know, all you had to do is say you were from England and people were like, ah! And, matter of fact, if you're from Liverpool, that really worked out well. Well, after a while, they ran out of bands in Liverpool, and some of them weren't very good. And Dave Clark was from Manchester. And Dave Clark heard the Beatles, but he wanted his band to sound a little different. And so his band had a saxophone player and a keyboard player very prominently. And they did produce some really good stuff. They also made a movie, which I haven't seen, but one time when you started in music back then, they put you in movies because they thought you'd only last for a year or two. So they were going to make as much money as they could before you were doomed. And that's what they do with the Beatles in Hard Day's Night and Help, which, by the way, amazing movies. The soundtrack, I used to play the soundtrack to Hard Day's Night in the car and sing it with my son when he was little. Now he listens to crap. I failed as a father. Anyway, he still likes some good stuff, but most of the time he plays garbage to annoy me. But that's what I did when I was a kid. I annoyed my parents with music. That way they stayed out of my room. And they didn't talk to me. That's another plus.
So you're getting your just dessert back.
Yeah. What goes around comes around. But at least I understand what's happening. All right, let's hear Dave Clark, and this is from their movie, which it was called Have a Wild Weekend, but I think they changed it to the name of the song, which I think is Catch Us If You Can. Catch you. Catch Us If You Can, because that's one of the best. But now, nah, yes, I'll run. I'm gonna run out. You know
gotcha.
How I'm.
I do know.
Yeah. Anyway, let's see. All right. We did. Oh well, yeah. That's when I'm talking about the Knickerbockers doing Lies. I swear, if you did not know that wasn't the Beatles, sounds just like them. I don't think we did a copy of that, did we?
We did.
Nah.
Make a look.
Yeah, you should. It's great. Every once in a while I post it on Facebook when I'm sick of politicians. And I dedicate it to whoever I'm ticked at. Now we're talking.
Oh, gosh.
The Yardbirds. Be still my foolish heart. Because the Yardbirds, they have a special place in English rock and roll. For matter of fact, any rock and roll, because they started what you could call the Holy Trinity of guitar heroes. The idea of that guy who plays guitar and everyone's just sitting there going, how does he do that? It's from those guys. I'll put it this way. When Jimi Hendrix went to England, there was only one man he wanted to meet. The same guy I want to meet. Eric Clapton. He got lucky. He got me. All right. Anyway, so the Yardbirds started out as a blues band. They're still around. They just played Hopewell recently. I was there. At the Beacon. They also played at Pocahontas a couple years ago, and I got the drummer's autograph. He's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And got my picture taken with him, shook hands with him. You see, stuff like that is cool. Y'all are sitting there, so what? But it's, you know, he got to play with those guys. All right, Eric Clapton started out there. He was in the band. What happened is they had another guitar player. Some of these stories, the guy was like 16, and his parents told him he couldn't quit school. And so they had to find another guitar player. And so Eric was watching the show, and matter of fact, he told the guy who was playing, he said, I'm gonna play better than you guy. And so they hired him. Problem was, they were doing too much pop music, and Eric at the time was a blues purist. Now he isn't. And so he left. And then they hired Jeff Beck, who can and will play anything. Probably the best guitar player I've ever seen. His problem is he can't write songs, and he's a horrible singer. But he's smart. He usually doesn't sing. And then you've got Jimmy Page, who later formed Led Zeppelin, who is good. Out of the three, give me Clapton and Beck. Led Zeppelin, cool if, you know, they reform or Jimmy Page does a band. I'll go, no doubt about it. But I'll never be excited as when I go to see Eric Clapton or when I go see Jeff Beck. And I've seen both of them several times, and they're definitely musical highlights. All right, so now I think we're gonna put the Yardbirds, who also influence bands like Aerosmith, and they also influence this one band called Count Five, who does this great song called Psychotic Reaction.
This train kept a rolling.
Ah, good. Train kept a rolling, which is Aerosmith tries to do this song. Trio led by a guy named Johnny Burnett, who actually, if you listen to some more of his stuff, is pretty cool too. You can find a lot of this stuff on XM. If you don't want to listen to regular radio, and I don't, because I hate commercials. Also, I don't like sifting through a bunch of garbage. They have channel specific stuff. So mine is Deep Tracks, which plays the album rock that you don't hear every time. When you listen to the classic rock station, you listen to 97.5, you're going to hear the same three Rolling Stone songs every time. You're going to hear Sympathy for the Devil, you're going to hear Satisfaction, and maybe Jumpin' Jack Flash, and then every once in a while they'll play some others. The Rolling Stones did amazing songs. Tremendous. Lots of stuff that you never get to hear. So, because I don't care how good a song is, you're going to get tired of it, except for one. There's one song I never get tired of. But, Layla, I never get tired of. Unless it's acoustic, that's sacrilege.
Yeah, we listened to that when you weren't here.
I tried to help.
Go ahead.
Okay, well, when you see the real thing, remember how you suffered when you heard it on acoustic. And then remember the sheer joy and bliss when you hear it the way it was meant to be. All right. Anyway, now we're getting somewhere. All right. As you know, this is my hero, Eric Clapton. He's the one with the perm. Back then, Bob Dylan was doing perms, and lots of guys wanted to be like Bob Dylan, so they perm. So you have a bunch of guys perming their hair. And also they're wearing very, very wild psychedelic clothes. But the thing is, this band was called Cream. What happened is, after Eric Clapton left the Yardbirds, he joined a band called John Mayall's Blues Breakers, who were playing blues, obviously. And at that time, that's all Eric wanted to play. By the way, John Mayall was in Richmond recently. I didn't go see him. He was playing some bar on Short Pump. That sort of thing freaks me out. But what also freaked me out is $80 to see him. No thank you. Part of the reason is John Mayall, although he was a good band leader, horrible singer. Horrible. And, I'd like to just cut the vocals off when I'm listening to that album. Because the music is amazing, but, then he opens his mouth, and you're like, oh, no. Anyway, Eric got sick of John's singing, and also John was sort of a dictator. So he went off with a bunch.